Hello, everybody. Hope you had a nice weekend. I had a Christmas party had a company Christmas party over the weekend, so that was pretty fun. Today we're gonna go ahead and work some more Novaculite. And that's what we're gonna do. It was really cold today. I was looking for my other glove and I can't find the dang thing. But any kind of, maybe this will work. Let's work this guy up. So here's what we got. This is actually really nice and waxy, so we'll see how this one goes. I want to try to work on getting things nice and thin. I want to do better. Did some hunting last night, which was awesome. A little bitty 3-point came in, and he came in pretty close, but he was too small to shoot. So he got a pass. Although I'm running out of time. Pretty soon the season's gonna be over. I'm gonna be without any venison for the spring and summer. But that's the way it goes. Shouldn't have missed the first deer I shot this year. Might be a nice little point in that flake. That's the end of that fun. Novaculite just may not be my material. At least for now. I might set the rest of this stuff off to the side till I get a couple more, another year of experience. Because this stuff is just... blasting right through it. It's not driving like I want it to. Just scoop that out. So probably a little point in that. Might do some small aggies. Here soon. Been seeing a lot of aggies online. Everybody's been doing aggies lately. I wanna play. Slowly but surely. Whoops. fickle. It's finicky stuff, man. Hit a similar platform, sometimes it'll do something different. I just need to do a bunch of bifacing. Just get a feel for it. Yeah, a few videos to put online, I haven't yet. You guys those. Gotta get that done. I'm gonna turn this on here. Not sure if it works at all, but like right there. Ow. Hit the tip of my finger. We had a problem area right here where it was part of the original spall, trying to zigzag it out, but where I hit it, it failed. So now I'm trying to fix it best I can. Can sometimes be easier said than done. Here's where we're at. We went around the whole thing. Now we got a workable edge. Now we're gonna go ahead and start chasing thickness and then figure out where we want the base and tip to be. So this is already pretty thin right here. And it's already squared off. There's a lot of good character here. I might pull the sides in. I don't know what I'm gonna make yet, because we've done a lot of them already. We haven't done a Bulbadeer yet. Maybe we'll do that. Or a Gary. We haven't done a Gary. An Evans. That one's kind of interesting. We do that. We got some options. What I'm going to do is just chase mass and see if I can thin this thing out a little bit more. I'm going to try to take my time. Even though I have trying to stay out of these bad habits. So I'd like to get this one down pretty thin. That's an interesting piece. Check that out. Has some character, that's for sure. we probably make this the tip. Alright. Make this the tip, because that's the thickest. Keep this as the base. I think that's what we'll do. Getting it worked up. I'm just gonna keep playing around with it. I gotta pull the sides in. I think I'm gonna keep working on this base a little bit. Maybe go a little smaller and fill it. I got a few. like a little bit of a crumbly mess right there. So we're gonna go ahead and try to clean that up a little bit. A little too deep on that one. Bite out of it. Thank you. until in a while. But we're getting it evened out, thinning it up. Probably switch over to the leg punch here soon. Although I only got another 6 minutes. So we may just clean up some edges here. Base thickness isn't too bad. It's got a low spot right here. I'm not sure what we're at thickness-wise. Yeah, we're still a little hefty. Now we're at 5. But I think we can get it thinner, especially in the tip. I think so anyway. And I think we still got enough to do. Yeah, we can probably still pull off a stem bulbed here. Plenty for a Gary, plenty for an Evans. We also got a Johnson here. Let's see what we can do. Cleaning that up. We'll go ahead and play with the shaft punch a little bit, or the leg punch a little bit. We got 5 minutes. So material's a little weird right in here. I think if you just think about it, it wants to step. Gotta switch up how I'm upgrading, I think. Try to maybe be a little bit lighter about it. see if that improves anything. I think you get a handle on got that tip whittled down pretty good. It's kind of hard to tell from the camera, but I think it's pretty decent. Here's where we're at. Like, I forgot to set a timer. We're gonna have to stop for tonight. Here's where we're at. See how we're doing on thickness here. I wanna get it down around quarter. We're at 5/16, right where that stack is. Definitely go a little thinner. It's a 5/16, quarter inch in the tip. 5/16, so we're getting pretty close. Maybe some indirect tomorrow will help thin that out even more. But here's where we're at. I just gotta keep working at it. Thanks for watching, everybody. Appreciate it. Bye. Hello, everybody. Hope you're doing good today. I'm gonna go ahead and try to finish up this Novaculite point that we started yesterday. It's really cold. In the garage again. Here's what we got. I think we were gonna go ahead and touch this up with indirect and see if we can't clean this up a little bit. It's got some really nice pattern in this thing. I might do a corner notch kind of point today. I don't know. We'll see. We'll try to clean up with some indirect. Try to warm up my glasses so they don't fog up a little bit. But not too hot, you don't want to burn your face. Let's see what we can do here. Strap's almost too small. Gotta get a few more laces here. I don't usually struggle this much, but I guess today is the day. Alright. That'll work fine. Definitely make a nice Evans. We could easily do a nice Bulbadeer. I don't mean it like that, but I'm just saying we have the option. We'll see what we can do about cleaning some of this stuff up here. There was a guy I met at the Flint Ridge Napin a few years ago. His name was Forrest. He was very good at indirect. He was doing some really nice work. I'm not there yet. But I tried. Definitely had it down pat. Definitely helped. Oops. Took a bite out of that one. Oh well. I was hoping it'd come all the way across and clean that up, but it didn't work out. Made myself a bit of a mess here. Something in the tip. It is not like it. Jack, we'll leave it alone. We're at a pretty consistent thickness. If you keep going any smaller, it'll end up being a different point today. Thank you. trying to clean up the edge symmetry a little bit. Heater a little too high. Here's where we're at. Just working on shape. Consistent thickness. So I think we're gonna go ahead and notch it. I think I'm just gonna do a nice corner notch and call it a day. That's what I like. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. I say nice, assuming that it works. Let's see how the notching gods are today. Probably not great. Probably not gonna use that. Grab my file off the bench over there. I was using it to rasp some wood. One second. Apologies. ran into a bit of a snag. Very crumbly right in that corner. There's one notch. I would have liked it to have gone a little deeper, but I think it'll be okay. On it. So I ran into it, just stopped. So instead of it flaking like it should have, it just hinged and broke off. I don't know why. So we're gonna keep trying to get it to go, but I don't think it's going. Try different notching tool if I can find it. I don't think those are gonna work. Another notching tool somewhere. I must have sat it down somewhere. that's gonna get any better. Unless I make the notch bigger. That doesn't guarantee it'll clean that off. Let's look. What to do there. All I'm doing is mangling my notcher. Well, that's annoying. Try and clean up the base. Make it look a little more intentional. See if that helps. A little bit. I think that just might have to be it. It's not ideal, but it's not the end of the world. Yeah, I think that's good. Probably punch notched it, but could have broke at that point, I reckon. Yeah, we'll leave it alone. Maybe we might be able to pass this off as a Williams. So here's what I come up with. Just couldn't quite get the notches to go. I mean, it just dead stopped right there. I don't know if you guys can see it or not, but when I went to it didn't, instead of it flaking, it hinged right here. I don't know. It is what it is. It's unfortunate, but oh well. Here's what we got. It's fairly clean for what it is. Give you some dimensions, and we'll check the book and see what we can call it. All right. I'm pretty happy with it. I mean, it looks pretty decent to me. So it is 2 5/8 by 1 3/8 by 5 16ths at the hump. And then the closer you get to the tip, it's a 1/4 inch, mid tip. Tip's about 3/16ths, tapers in. So I think overall it's not bad. It's got a pretty good center line. It's pretty flat. Pretty good lenticular. Let's see what we can call this thing. I think we can call it a Williams, but we'll see. So I believe it's South Central region. Go to a Williams. Or we'll just call it a corner notch and make it vague. So Williams is a corner notch sharp triangle. Mine's a little more blade like, but some of these smaller ones are more round. I don't know. I don't think this would pass as a Williams. That's the closest thing I have that I know is Novaculite type. Holy crap, Pedernales? Never mind. Sorry. So yeah, I think that's what we're gonna call it. We'll just call it a generic corner notch. If I can find a name for it, I'll give it one. But thanks for watching, everybody. I appreciate it. Bye.